Good morning, everyone. I'm going to present a case on Tata Ace Gold. I've had over 25 years of experience in advertising. I've been fortunate enough to be part of a team that has won many awards over the years. But I'm particularly happy with this particular thing that I was involved with. So I'll just take you through the case study. Obviously, given the topic, I'll just give you a snapshot from a TV perspective. The entire case study is a little more detailed, but is available on Google and online. So you can go through it for a deeper understanding. Two, three things that I would like to comment on before I start the case study. One is, you know, my belief is that irrespective of the medium, whether it's TV, digital, I think unless you have an insight and a brand idea in place, the medium is not so important. Depending on the insight and the brand idea, I think the medium will fall in place. I think that's a big caveat, because the point I'm making is, in today's day, because of digital and e-commerce, there seems to be a rationalization of the consumer mindset. You know, over the past 10 years, we've been subjected to everything regarding price. You know, I mean, earlier it was an Alan Solly or a Peter England or let's say a Louis Philippe. There was a certain distinctive personality to the kind of brands that you bought. But today it's just, the price. Actually, there's a threat to the brand. Which is why my belief is, which is why I'm also very happy with this. Because if you have a classic insight and a brand story, it really works in the long run. Okay? The digitization of the rationalization is actually putting pressure on brands. The third point I would like to make is that, I will not attempt this TV first from a media and measurement metrics, because there are a lot of other experts that are obviously going to talk about it. I will just talk about it from a creative and a marketer perspective, why I believe TV should be the first medium, not the only medium. And we have the next slide, please. Okay, you will have to bear with me for the next 2-3 slides, because this might be an alien category for a lot of you. So, to give a context to this Ace Gold, I need to go back about 15 years back. This was when we launched the Ace, which all of you would be aware of as a product that you see on the roads. But to give a context, it's a very fascinating, it's actually like a Nirma or a precursor to the Nano. You know, in those years, there's a below 1-ton category, which is only being serviced by large three-wheelers, the goods carriers. And as a company, we were not present in that segment. And obviously, that was the fastest growing segment, because post-liberalization, you know, with the FMCG brand, durable companies coming, last mile transportation was exploding. So, Tata Motors realized that we need to be present in the segment, otherwise we lose our leadership. So, the challenge that was taken upon by the company was, yes, we would need to be present in the large three-wheeler space, but we cannot have a me-too product. So, the company, the manufacturing took on itself, within 4 years, developed a product called the Ace, which was launched at the price of a three-wheeler. You know, that was a phenomenal product innovation that created history. Obviously, for 5 years, we wiped out the large three-wheelers out of the market, and we had enjoyed 100% market share. That was the context of when we launched it. Okay, and yeah, next slide, please. There were 2-3 things. One is obviously price. It's like a Nirma. It is the price for the strong pillar of the Ace brand. Second was that in terms of respect, you know, the sales slogan was, because you have to compare it to a three-wheeler. Three-wheeler and a taxi, there's a status difference. You know, auto is an auto, taxi is a taxi. The fourth wheel of respect, the teen chakka mehnat ka, ek chakka izzat ka, was the sales slogan that was carried into the field. And we also, from a brand idea, we said people buy products, not for a functional use. He's not going to buy the Ace to transport an X-Tool. He's buying it for employment. It's a tool for entrepreneurship. So we shifted the game into share of employment rather than share of market. So our entire marketing was about how do I make people enter the commercial category as a respectable means of earning a livelihood. It's not that it's a better product. So there's a huge emotional shift that we took, which is why, the next slide please, we were a constant leader. Okay, for many a year. The next slide, please. Okay, so many a year, we have, in fact, for 5 years, we were the only player. And obviously, after that, the competition came in. And over the years, till about 2017, what was happening was, because the competition entered, and obviously, as the competition entered, they will come with, you know, more features, you know, better powered engines and XYZ. So, all the players are playing in this catch-up game from a product feature point of view. So, over the years, we were facing challenge in terms of market share and leadership was becoming threatened. And without realizing it, the price point of that category itself was moving up. So what was affordability was a key appeal to the bottom end of the pyramid who was searching for a means of employment, no longer was of value. Okay, so suddenly there was this realization that if we need to crack the bottom of the pyramid, which was our original, you know, the marketing strategy, we need to drop the price point. But that's easier said than done. So next slide, please. So one of the guys, this is an interesting, this is where the twist actually starts. So there was this discussion in the plant as to, you know, how do we launch a product which is much cheaper than the existing one. So if you notice, this was the original Ace, and there were obviously a lot of facelifts and stuff like that. So compare it to the old Maruti 800 and let's say the new Maruti 800. So someone said, why don't we bring back the old Ace? Well, you know, all the dyes and all have been accounted for. We can launch it at a much cheaper rate. So the decision was taken to relaunch the original Ace. Now, this was a manufacturing call, but from a marketer perspective, you know, when you first hear it, you keep saying, how can that be? You know, here is a company, we're trying to move ahead. How can you bring back an old vehicle, dust it off the shelves and bring it back? You know, it's going to affect the brand in the long run. But the call was taken that, no, to survive in this marketplace, because you realize over the past 2 years, the economy has been very tough, that we need to have a lower end variant. It doesn't matter. Okay, so, but as a marketing department, this was like, you know, anathema to us. Okay, this was going to be a big area because the status, the empowerment, that was going to be a threat. But we took up on this challenge. So what we did was, this is where the insight comes. Go to the next slide. So what we did was, we just changed the thing into, we said, okay, fine. There must have been other brands that have been brought out of the market share. Okay, so we took on examples like Ray-Ban, Coke, Levi's, where you realize if you change old to classic or vintage, actually it's the same, but it's just how you play with the mind of the consumer. Okay, and this is what we did for the sales force in the dealership, because forget TV or radio, it is your sales guy and the dealership was the frontline medium. If you're not going to convince him, if he's going to still treat it, whatever your plans you make at the marketing headquarters, he's not going to understand where you're coming from. Okay, so it was important to have this sessions across where we pep them up with the fact that old is actually gold, it's a classic. Okay, this is a subtle shift, but it's a very important shift. Next slide, please. So this is where we did a lot of internal campaigns equating it to gold. That's why we called it the Ace Gold. They say it's timeless, prices never goes out of fashion. Please don't treat it as a gold. And actually, we had an entire marketing rollout internally and with the dealerships. You know, we treated it like a new product. It's like bringing, let's say, a vintage Rolls Royce back. We never held back. It was a very important cog in the wheel for, you know, transforming our entire system to actually go out instead of saying it's suspect. No, it's a very important thing. Then, obviously, then came the advertising. So, since we always stood for respectable means of earning a livelihood, we had to, you know, retain that because that's the mother brand equity. But how do we, you know, ensure this continues in the same thing? Fortunately, unfortunately, India, as everybody is aware, unemployment has become a huge crisis. It was always a crisis because apart from we being a young population in the country, in the world, one data point which nobody realizes, is till date, 70% of the youth don't go from 12th to the college. You know, the dropout from the 12th. So people drop out of 7th standard, 8th standard. Beyond 12th is only 30% of the people actually go to college. So forget about unemployed graduates. You know, look at the people who are 12th and below, and you couple it with the youngest population in the world and, you know, 130 crores population. That's a huge potential of people who are attaining, let's say, 2021 and struggling now what to do in life. Look at the pressure it faces in the family system. So we took the same thing and we said, okay, it is your commercial vehicle, your CV is your CV for life. Okay, that's the insight that we took, and we have this commercial. This is the next slide. I'll just play this on.
Beta, naukri ka kya ho?
Kya hoga maa? Sifarish kahan se lata?
Lunch chahiye. Pension nahi.
Ab to ho bhi chhod diya dada. Beta, lagta hai teri chitthi aayi hai. Dear Raji, hame ye batate hue khushi hoti hai ki aapko ek achhi naukri mil gayi. Lagbhag 25,000 kamai hogi tumhare papa. Beta, offer manzoor ho to joining date bata do. Apno ka jo dil hota hai, वो गोल्ड का होता है। टाटा एस गोल्ड, कामयाबी कल आज और कल
ओके श्योर आई लाइक टू मेंशन टू थ्री थिंग्स एज टू व्हाई वी यूज टीवी ओके To me, my belief is, you know, if we need to build an emotion and a brand story, there's nothing like an audiovisual medium and TV, obviously. And second is that TV gives you an advantage because stories are built over time. And this is the only medium that allows me, you know, to go back to you time and again with the same commercial. Because the story, especially, it's not an impulse product, it's a TV. If I need, it's like a life career choice for the youngster, you know, from becoming a doctor or engineer or Swiggy delivery boy. I'm telling you, why don't you become a niche owner? That takes time. Okay. For that, TV is a medium where I can keep bombarding. I can't do that with any other medium. Second is, if you look into the audience, is not the youngster necessarily. It is a father, it's a mother, it's a grandmother, it's a sister. It's a family decision. Okay. So, if I need to reach, and obviously in India, you know, 80% plus is still single TV owning households. So, where else would you get a family watching this? And plus, we are, you know, we are, as consumers, we are creatures of habit. If you have control of the medium, you tend to skip it. Or you have, you know, digitally you skip it. And TV, we are used to, at least the middle India, they're used to seeing the breaks. Okay? And the TV chalta rehta, they keep on watching it. So over a period of time, the story was built. Okay? And that was a large reason. Plus this, I think that as the lady was talking about 100% coverage, which is a very important factor. Because which are the medium, because you're forced to watch it, I mean, it builds over time, that necessity. It's like a front page in a, Times of India, day in and day out. You just can't miss it. Passive viewing, that depends on the creative. If you have a good enough creative, you will definitely get eyeballs. That passive equation will change. Okay. Then the other thing that we did coming from TV, you know, for TV, actually we look at them as not media partners, but as marketing partners. So when we brief them, it is, you know, part of it is the media buys. Part of it is, okay, how can you leverage my brand idea in your channel, in the programs that we take? So let's say for, you know, let's say any singing program, Sarigamapa. We have a special award for a singer who may not be the top three, who may be in the top 10, but is economically backward. So we institute an award and we give it away at the grand finale. There are a lot of things that we do. For example, in one case study with Sony, you know, they had an interesting program called Crossroads. It was done by Ram Kapoor. It was a live audience where it was written by Bahubali directors, Rajmouli. So it's a nice format. It's about how all of us in life, sometimes we come at a crossroads and the choice that you make dictates the life you lead. For example, a girl who always wanted to be air hostess gets married and the next day she gets an appointment letter with British Airways. So what does she do with the marriage or does she take up a job? Or the guy who's always wanting an international posting, okay, but suddenly his father falls ill. So what are the choices you make? And you know, the Ram Kapoor throws upon that situation to the audience and it's a debate about which road should you take. So in that program, we've integrated within the program itself. I'm just not talking about media buy. That can only be possible in TV. Let me just show this.
Tata Ace Gold presents Crossroads. Budhwar se Shukrawar aap sare aaye hain samay.
Jo raay par khadi zindagi ko jab kamyabi ke sunahre pankh lagte hain, tab zindagi jeene ki khwahish dugni ho jati hai. Aise hi Tata Ace Gold ki inspirational kahani dikhayenge, जिसमें रुकावटें तो काफी थी लेकिन एक फैसले से कामयाबियों ने झूम कर कदम चूम. तो आइए आप और हम मिलकर देखते हैं ऐसी ही दिल छू लेने वाली एक कहानी.
सपने कठिनाइयों से जूझने की ताकत देते हैं या फिर उन सपनों को भूलने की वजह भी बनते हैं. मुंबई के आलम खान की जिंदगी के सफर में एक ऐसा ही मोड़ आया.
हमारे भाई लोग रहते थे लेकिन कोई सपोर्ट करने को राजी नहीं था. पहले कैसा था कि 20 रुपया 50 रुपया खर्ची मिलती थी हफ्ते में. फिर मैं टैक्सी चलाता था, उसमें आमदनी नहीं थी कि मैं अपने बच्चों की परवरिश कर सकूं.
आलम की जिंदगी में एक ऐसा मोड़ आया जब उनको अपनी बेटियों के भविष्य और अपनी रोजमर्रा की जरूरतों के बीच एक को चुनना था. पर आलम ने समझौता नहीं, कामयाबी चुनी.
हमारे दोस्त ने एडवाइस दिया टाटा एस ले लीजिए. उसके बाद में नसीब मेरी बदल गई. हम टाटा एस के जरिए कमाए, अच्छा कमाए. फिर आज मैं अपने बच्चों को अच्छी तालीम दे रहा हूँ और उनको बैंक के मीडियम से पढ़ा रहा हूँ. टाटा एस ना एक हमारे आमदनी का जरिया है, टाटा एस का हम शुक्र गुजार हैं.
आलम की तरह एस ने लिखी है 20 लाख कहानियाँ. टाटा एस, 20 लाख कहानियाँ, 20 लाख कहानियाँ.
So we had created a lot of consumer testimonials because of our 15-year heritage of creating wonderful cases. Today, many people are actually 50 crores of business kings or 100 crores. There are many famous stories. And actually, the real Bankadia scripture is the customer testimony. Next, please.
Tata Ace Gold.
The other thing I was talking about, how you can use TV to build a chapter in a story. Okay, then at a certain point of 6 months on land, we had crossed 20 lakhs. And we took that again to television. It gave us an opportunity to build on the fact that, you know, there are a lot of fence sitters who are still considering it and how we use this effectively.
से अब तक हर 3 मिनट एक नई कामयाबी.
So, this is how we kept building up the story. And the next one, we tied up with the gold. You don't have to show the commercial. You know, we looked at various ways of again building up the association with the gold, which was, again, television gave us a huge platform. And fortunately, coincidentally, there was this song called Garlao Gold within this movie itself. How we actually used it to tie up with our overall umbrella brand advertising. We don't have time, so we can just go to the next one. And even on digital, it's not that we didn't do digital, but what we did was we used the brand idea of employment and actually took it to digital. So I won't show you the commercial, but we actually had this real-time contest where Akshay Kumar says, "Ab naukri dhoondh rahe ho, I will give you an appointment later." So, encouraging people to actually write in with business ideas about how they would use the ACE. It was like a Shark Tank, which you took this contest across the country with a grand finale where Akshay Kumar actually gave away 10 vehicles to the 10 most brilliant ideas. And it was the amazing talent that this country has in terms of ideas. The only limitation is the money that they have. Next. Don't show the commercial. One last bit again. I mean, this obviously the amount that we did was huge, but you know, one of this is important. I put this, you know, we had this Rozgar Express because as an employment drive, you know, instead of going to the normal nakas and, you know, the traditional beat areas, we used to take it to lower income areas and talking about unemployment. Okay. And we're counselors. But the interesting part here, why I wanted to mention this was in the evening when we had the counselor session where we invited people during the day, every person who walked in was an elder with a son or just elder. So that so which meant the TV advertising is working. You would normally expect the youngsters to come for this counseling session. No. It was always either the parents or an elder or accompanied by the youngster. That's how this phenomenally the television actually worked. But the many cases like that, I just restricted to that. And we grew by 83% last year. And within that, Ace Gold, as a sub-brand, we'll go to the next slide, has become 60-70% of the portfolio. And more importantly, nearly one in every Ace Gold is a first-time user. He was not a category entrant in the first place. So, which is either the underemployed or much fresher who's not considering a commercial vehicle came into it, which was a phenomenal cut. Because you'll have to realize it's an entry level, it's a career choice. If I haven't captured at the bottom level, which is the Ace, then I have him for life. Okay, so that it is a phenomenal case study for us, and today we are reaping actually the dividends out of that and also helping the overall Ace brand portfolio. And I believe TV played a huge role in building this equity of the Ace, and we protected the Ace brand, which was very important. Otherwise, it would have become, you know, a price discounting like what it's doing today.